How does it feel to be a part of this year's Fright Fest?
Very, very good. Slightly frightening. So far, I've found 8 people just in the audience that are much more frightened than anything in our film. But it's good. It's very, very interesting. Really good.
I've been to Fright Fest before. With a film we did called Kill List a couple of years ago. And, you know, it's they're proper fans. It's a really amazing genre event. And I'm hoping this film tonight, Borderlands, goes down well.
It is like starting by showing it to the world's best experts on your genre. So, we should really have tried out with a few other people first. But here we are. We're here, we're nervous, and we're hoping it's going to go well.
Gordon's absolutely right. It's the world premiere tonight, so nobody's really seen this film. Neither Gordon nor myself have seen the finished film.
And certainly not the director or the producer. So it's going to be interesting. We're really looking forward to it. But it will be slightly at the back of the theatre, looking like that.
Fans who are very excited about the film, can you just start by giving us a quick synopsis and telling us where both of your characters fit in?
Well, very briefly, it's about a team from the Vatican who is a call up to go and investigate this possible miracle and in a church in the West Country of England. And then
we find there are strange things going on. We investigate it deeper and we get well and truly
sucked in
to a very strange and rather frightening experience. And he plays a computer geek because it's a found footage film. So he plays a very sexy, erudite and an incredibly beautiful geek who does all the cameras. And I'm a Vatican
investigator,
hence the beard.
It's a procedural investigatory film, and with a sort of horror and suspense elements. I don't want to say too much about it because you're about to watch it.
Yeah, but it's great. That's all that matters. All right. And if you don't think it's great, see him. It's not my fault. All right, it's his fault.
Well, the challenges of making a found footage film are actually legion, particularly in our case, because the cameras are sort of CCTV, more traditional found footage type scenarios. But we have cameras strapped to our heads the whole time. So I suppose that's the sort of uniqueness of this particular approach, is that the cameras are actually mounted to our heads as lipstick cameras. And the challenge of shooting that is extraordinary insofar as you have to have the camera operator, in our case, also the DOP, Evan Bolter, literally glued to you. I mean, we on a couple of takes, Evan and I would link belts in our trousers so that he couldn't. We would be walking in step the whole time, like a three-legged race. And you're actually having to do action sequences, running and jumping and so forth, tied to someone else. And not like climbers tied to someone else. I mean, we have to be really, really linked together. So there's a challenge there. In terms of why they succeed, I think, it does create an extraordinary immediacy for the audience.
That's the point. It's immediacy and it's the documentary feel of it. So it feels that there's a truth to it as you're going on. And it feels, and it should. And the performances should feel like you are, it's sort of being made up on the hoof as you go along. And that is a really nice thing to do. So you can do a lot of improvisation around what the script is, which is quite good.
And there's a grammar to this stuff in found footage films. There's a grammar, you have to watch YouTube to see what found footage looks like. And to a certain degree, it's about adhering to that grammar and making sure that the sort of photographic elements of the film make sense of that grammar and adhere to it, and that you're not just suddenly breaking the kind of paradigm that you're in, like that movie End of Watch, which was a fantastic film recently, but that was a supposed found footage film, but it kind of, after about 20 minutes, they just gave up. And you think, well, there's supposed to be 2 cameras operating here, and now one guy's in this room and one guy's in that room, and now there's a third camera, and I was watching it going, well, it doesn't quite add up.
It does make the audience a character in the film. So when something scary happens, you react to it like you're the person. You go, what was that? So the camera does that for you. So it just adds to the... It should really involve you as an audience member, as a character in the story.
In filmmaking terms, you might say the entire film is a point of view shot. It's about point of view. It's a POV. And in this instance, very literally, it's a POV that you have the camera attached to the actor's heads. and that really does, as Gordon's saying, that does put you in the action, and hopefully does ramp up the tension, ramp up the excitement, and make it a much more involving and immersive experience.